Hello guys, welcome everyone to another video of the Tech Show. We all know that there's a ton of Android emulators for Windows, from which finding the best one is a really hectic task. But today, we are gonna find out the best performing Android emulator for Windows. We will decide that upon the benchmarks of Geekbench and gameplay. Since I have a really weak PC, configuration of i3 7th gen and 4GB RAM only, so you will get much more greater results if you have a good PC. I will just give you a general idea of the optimization of the emulators. If they can run well in my system, then it is really optimized for other systems too. The emulators I chose to give a try were LDplayer, Memu, Nox and Gameloop. So let's get started serially. At first, I will download all of them and install. Links will be in the description. To give you guys a perfect idea about these emulators, I will show their useful features. Each emulator has its own special features. In the end of the video, I will tell you which emulators are the best for which use cases. I will install Geekbench 3 and run a benchmark. It scored 2511 in single core and 6017 in multi-core. I had to use Geekbench 3 since Gameloop is based on Android 4.4 KitKat, and KitKat doesn't support later versions of Geekbench, and I couldn't even run GTA Vice City. It just crashed for no reason. It has really poor stability, and you cannot trust this for other games. So let's check MemuPlay. It has a score of 3074 in single core and 6478 in multi-core. It's better than Gameloop. Settings, as you can see on screen, MemuPlay is based on Android Nugget. It will support much more apps than other emulators. It also supports high refresh rate. Next candidate is LDplayer. LDplayer has a nice clean UI and looks better than others. It supports to a maximum of 120Hz, which is really amazing. So in Geekbench, it has a single core score of 3145 and multi core score of 6547. LDplayer ran GTA Vice City best comparing to the other three emulators. But for some reason, my recorder froze while recording. It's such a shame. But I assure you, it performed better than others. Now let's see how Nox performs. It is also based on Android Lollipop, so it has not very much good app support. but the emulator has a lot of features. In Geekbench, it scored 3053 in single core and 6386 in multi-core. Let's run GTA Vice City on Nox. As you can see, it delivered a really bad performance. It was lagging and stuttering all over. Not well optimized in a word. And I tried this with the max setting possible, 4 cores and 2GB RAM in all emulators. Try to avoid Nox. So we came to an ending. Let's state the final results. Playing only PUBG Mobile and COD Mobile, Tencent Gameloop should be good enough, but not for anything else. It is worst among these all other emulators. It has a lack of features compared to others too. Gameloop takes the fourth place. Now let's talk about Nox Player. Nox Player takes the third position. It is loaded with features but not stable at all. Barely could run the GTA Vice City. MemuPlayer takes the second position. For gamers, it should be good enough. It is a really decent emulator. It has high refresh rate support too and features a lot of functions like file transfer between guest and host easily. And optimized too. It is a nice emulator. But I think LDplayer did the best in my opinion. It delivers 120Hz fluid UI and best Geekbench scores among them. In gaming, it also did the best. If you are looking for gaming and smooth emulator for general Android tasks like using Facebook, Messenger, WhatsApp, LDplayer is unbeatable. It is the best among them. It has a lot of other features too, like drag and drop APK files, file sharing between guest and host, macro, and a lot of other features. So I think that should be good for today. See you tomorrow.